be the first on your block to be injected, to have this needle implanted into your child's hand, or maybe in the forehead. Are you beginning to feel like a number?
This fascinating system is based on the reading of radio frequencies from a minute microchip. The conclusive results indicate that this form of identification is safe and successful to all species.
Some people call it the mark of the beast. They were all earmarked for extermination.
Electronic identification using the microchip system.
I'm He's really going to do it. He'll kill us all if he don't get us out of here now.
We'll be right back. head of his prone naked body.
Yeah. It's my terminology that strikes the mind and puts the beat apart. You know the many styles I choose will boost from the start. I come off the street, that's all I see. I know that with the rhythm. Incisions are made into the pain, and then I begin to get them on the bottom. Follow me, say when you're winning, la 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 la
I see the monster. I don't know, but I do believe that, you know, I obviously saw some things, and nobody's been able to tell me what I saw, so I think I must have seen the monster.
Unexplained disturbance and the hysteria that is causing are incredible.
Now there's a master underground computer that's capable of controlling everything on Earth. Now there's a master underground computer that's capable of controlling everything on Earth.
Unexplained disturbance and the hysteria that is causing are incredible.
Now there's a master underground computer capable of controlling everything on Earth.
Unexplained disturbance and the hysteria that is causing are incredible.
Oh, The mark of the beast. If you look in the back of the Bible, Revelation 12, it says he or she will not be able to buy or sell without say having the mark of the beast in their palm of their hand or your forehead.
Huge engines, super tractors, gigantic cranes, mechanical saws, dynamic dredgers, even psychological thought reading devices clash with one another in the hall of a great exhibition. During the night, the machines break through the walls of the auditorium and run wild in the streets, destroying homes, knocking over towers, devastating fields. Military might is mobilized and army artillery is dispatched to destroy the machine monsters. But the guns and tanks and cannons refuse to fire on their fellow machines and instead join the rebels. A few human beings escape and from a mountainside watch the destruction of their man-made world.
Thank you. I'm convinced, after 13 years of study and investigation, that the Earth is being visited by intelligently controlled extraterrestrial vehicles whose origin, in other words, is off the Earth. So-called flying saucers, in other words, are real. Now, the terms flying saucers and UFOs have been used to mean a great many things. What I mean are the reports of things having definite size, shape, and texture, and behavior that's very peculiar, that is unlike things that we know how to make. And reports like this that cannot be identified as known phenomena by competent investigators. This is perhaps 10 to 20% of the total number of reports that have been examined by investigators. Now, the phenomena is worldwide. It's been going on heavily for 25 years, and sort of lightly for 2,500 years, as far as we can tell. Every country in the world, all kinds of people.
Of astrology? Do you believe that there is order and genius in 100,000 million galaxies similar to our own? Do you believe that the life of our bodies is the beginning and end? Or do you believe in reincarnation? Perhaps in heaven and in hell? Do you believe in prophecy and
cannot cannot be captured and cataloged by physical science for the simple reason that they are not physical. They are far greater. They belong to the mind, to the spirit. They are the ultimate reality. They are free of the bonds of time and space. They are everywhere, always, yes.
We'll be right back. Can you imagine extraterrestrial?